Hi, from this tutorial I will share you how to create a custom scene in your ECR Spatial Anchor project. Okay, let's get started. First you want to go to Assets ECR Spatial Anchor Scenes folder and create a new scene. I keep it as new scene, and you want to load it by double click on it. Okay, when you go to your new scene, you can see main camera and direction light. You want to delete main camera first. Then you can right click on your hierarchy window and go to XR AR session origin. And also you want to right click on hierarchy window and go to XR and AR session. Okay, we have added AR session origin game object and AR session game object. Then you can expand your AR session origin game object and you can see AR camera here. And also you want to add AR default point cloud to it. So I right click on AR session origin and select AR default point cloud. You should drag and drop this AR default point cloud into AR session origin game object as a child. Okay, then select AR session origin. Then you have to add some components to here. First, you want to add AR anchor manager. And then AR plane manager. Then AR raycast manager. Then AR point cloud manager. For AR point cloud manager, you can see point cloud preview. You have to drag and drop this AR point cloud game object into this point cloud prefab here. Okay, now go to hierarchy window again and right click on it, create empty game object, reset this position as 000. You want to rename it spatial anchor config. Then you want to add a script to it. Click add component and search spatial anchor manager script. Okay, you have already put your credentials in ECR spatial anchors, Azure spatial anchor SDK and resources, and you can see spatial anchor config file. You have already put your credentials. So you don't want to put same credentials in spatial anchor config. If you want, you can add them, or otherwise you can ignore them. Then create new empty game object again and name it as selector. You have to add two script here. Click add component and search item selector script and select it. And you have to add another component. Click add component, search scale rotate handler script. Now you want to create your canvas hierarchy window. For that you have to create new empty game object, rename it as UX. Then go to your prefab folder in ECR spatial anchors prefabs and drag and drop a canvas game object into your UX. Now canvas is child of UX game object. In canvas game object, you can see the main panel, expand it, and you can change your caption. By default, it name as basic demo. You can change it as you see, or whatever the name you can give it as a caption. then you can change the subheading also, and icon image and the titles, and it already have create scene button and localized button. Next, you want to create a new empty game object again. Name it as App Manager, and you want to add some components here. First, add App State Manager. And Cloud Anchor Session Manager and Scenery Persistent Manager and Scenery Placement Manager also UI Manager Demo then you want to add Placement Cursor Manager. Then you want to add Cloud Anchor Script. Then you want to add Place Object Scenery Script. Finally, you want to add Basic Demo Controllers. In UI Manager Demo Script, it will ask UI Log Output Text. You can give it by expanding UX, go to canvas, and the first element as text. I have already disabled it. You can drag and drop here. And also it will ask UI pan and delete item. You can give it by go to UX, canvas, and delete panel. That panel also by default disabled. Then you can go to your basic demo controller script here, and it will ask instruction panel 1. You have to go to UX, canvas, instruction panel, and drag and drop this instruction panel into instruction panel 1. Then it will ask instruction panel 2. Drag and drop instruction panel 2. It will automatically disable, and also it will ask back to menu button. You have to drag and drop this disable back to menu game object, drag and drop here. Okay, now you have set up your app manager game object. Also, you want to create a new game object called general configuration. I'm right click on hierarchy and create empty and name it as general configuration. Then you want to add general configuration script from ECR spatial anchor script folder. So I add component and search general configuration script here and add it to our general configuration game object. Then it will ask placement cursor prefab and spatial anchor group prefab under visual items. You have to go to ECR spatial anchors prefab folder, and you can see for placement cursor prefab, I drag and drop this placement cursor prefab from prefab folder to here. For spatial anchor group prefab, you want to add your anchor prefab from prefab folder to here. I have already talked about how to get API URL Cloud Anchor ID from setting up your Unity package tutorial. So you can see that tutorial and get a knowledge how to put your API URL Anchor ID. For now, I am going to my basic demo scene. And go to general configuration and copy this string URL, redirect to our new scene again and paste in this input box. Okay, now you have set up your new scene. Then you have to add a scenery prefab item here. That's one. I want to add only a one game object, so I put it as one. And then I search rocket object from prefab folder. Go to prefab folder and drag and drop this rocket prefab from prefab folder to here. If you want to create your own ECR spatial anchor prefab, you have to follow simple steps. For example, I will create a rocket prefab. For that, in hierarchy window, I'm right click on hierarchy window and create empty game object and name it as rocket, and reset the positions, rotation and scale values to 0. I redirect to my rocket game object and drag and drop rocket game object to this empty game object here. Then our rocket game object is a child of rocket empty game object. Then you want to add a box collider here. Then double click on rocket game object. And you can see your box collider by clicking on edit collider button here. And you can see box collider is too big, so I reduce the size of my box collider. Then you have to add another component. Click add component, search scenery item prefab details and add this script. You can see in this script you have to provide item name, enable rotation feature is already checked, and enable scale feature is already checked. From this feature enabled, you can easily rotate and scale your prefab. And also the factor is given, how much of rotate and scale factor should be changed. By default, it rotate factor is 650 and the scale factor is 400, and the item name should be the game object name. So I copy this game object name from here and paste into item name. Yes, that's about creating your ECR spatial anchor prefab. Drag and drop this rocket game object into your prefab folder. Okay, now you have successfully created your ECR spatial anchor prefab. Now you can build your new scene. Go to file, build setting, and remove all these scenes from here and drag and drop your new scene and then build your scene. Thank you.